Then, Diesel had an idea. A very Christmas bad idea. I know just what to do. Oh no, Diesel 10, not another plan. Don't you remember what happened last year and the year before? Ugh, who cares about last Christmas and the Christmas before? I have an idea to stop Christmas from coming! Now I'm gonna give you instructions what to do. And I want you to do it! So Diesel 10 told Ari, Bert, and Diesel what to do. Diesel was told to do something naughty, and Ari and Bert to do something very, very, very naughty. As soon as Sir Totten Hat is shocked what's happened, he'll definitely cancel Christmas. Ha ha ha! You're a mean one! Diesel 10! You dominate the line! You're as funny as a scrap, and I don't really have the time, Diesel 10! You're a slimy diesel with a claw that seems to have its own mind! Just face the music, you're psychotic! Diesel 10! You're a heartless rolling troll! Enjoying one trick monster movie that never sold, Diesel 10! I really thought it was funny when you fell off that bridge! True feature! Given the choice between the two of you, I choose the rotten pastry tart. Pinchy's hungry. So Diesel, Ari, and Bert went to do what Diesel 10 told them to do. Back at Nafford Station, Sir Topham Hatt was talking to Thomas. Thomas, I would like you to fetch some Christmas lights from the yard and take them to the steamworks for the party on Thursday. Yes, sir. Lady, I would like you to take some passengers from Nafford to Maithwaite. Yes, sir. And Percy, I would like you to take some garland to Tidmouth Sheds. Yes, sir. So the engines went to do their jobs they were told to do.
Thomas arrived at the yard and backed up to the flatbed with the Christmas lights on it. But Diesel was in the yard too. Now we'll ruin Christmas, what Diesel 10 told us to do. And he charged and gave the flatbeds an extra big shunt. Christmas lights flew into the air and the boxes opened and the lights smashed and broke all over Thomas. There were blue lights, red lights, green lights, and other colored lights. Thomas had glass all over him. Ha 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 ha! Lighty boiler! Ha 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 ha! And Diesel rolled away. Ugh, here we go again! Lady collected the passengers. And puffed over the viaduct. But when he turned to Ben, Ari was in her way. Ari, get out of the way! Move, please! But Ari wasn't listening.
Siesta. Yo.
Sorry about that. Ari, I said move! But Ari didn't move. Ari! Lady was getting so annoyed that she didn't know that the points were changed because Ari told the signalman to change them. Ari, for the last time, move! Then there was trouble. Wait, why am I going to the siding? Oh no! Oh! Oh! Screech! Lady hit a set of buffers. And stopped. Oh! Luckily, no one was hurt. Ha ha! Ari rolled away, laughing. Ugh, Thomas was right. We should have known this was gonna happen again. Meanwhile, Percy collected the garland. From the docks. But Bert was at the docks too. Heh heh. Be ready to be tangled up, Percy. And just like Diesel did to Thomas, he gave the freight cars a huge shunt. Garland flew into the air and landed all over Percy. Ugh! Bust my buffers! Percy was cross what Bert did. Ha ha! And Bert just ran off laughing. Ugh, not this again. That evening, Sir Tottenham came to see Lady Thomas and Percy. Why haven't you three done the jobs I told you to do? We're sorry, sir, but we all have stories. Diesel gave the flatbeds a huge shunt and the lights landed on me and broke. Ari diverted me into a siding and the passengers could have got hurt. And Bert also gave the truck a huge shunt and Garland landed all over me. Sir Topham Hatt looked stern.
Ugh, this again. Those naughty diesels. They're trying to do it on purpose, sir.
Just why? Why does Diesel 10 not like Christmas?
We'll find out soon.
I'm sorry for doubting it was your fault, Engines. You go home and get some sleep.
I'll try and figure out what I can do. That night when Thomas, Lady, and Percy told the other engines, they were also worried too. Oh, well, Diesel 10 really is acting like the Grinch now. Cause remember last year when he burned down the Christmas tree? I agree. Diesel 10, Diesel Irie, and Bert have caused a lot of confusion and delay last year. And they did the same the year before. Well, we can't just let them ruin Christmas again. We have to
stop them, no matter what they do.
Yes, good idea, Thomas. Besides, steamies are better than diesel engines.
And we'll prove Diesel 10 that.
All the engines agreed to Thomas. They know no matter what happens, they have to stop the diesels from ruining Christmas. This is like Home Alone. The third one. Agree, Percy. And all the engines went to sleep. And Lady spent the night at Tidmouth Sheds. At the diesel works. Diesel 10 was proud of what Diesel Irie and Bert did. Well done! Now those engines will have to do their jobs tomorrow! And while they're working, we'll burn up their Christmas tree at Tidmouth Sheds! And steal all their decorations and everyone else's decorations around the island! And then we'll prove Sir Topham Hatt
that diesel engines are better than steam engines.